Now, what is the other type listed here? Present value of an annuity due. The annuity due is what? That means you're going to get the money at the beginning of the year. Now notice on all of them, how much is a dollar today worth? A dollar. A dollar today buys a dollar. There's no inflation, no deflation between now and now. What happened? So nothing material. So that's 1.0. And then a dollar today and a dollar a year from today would be worth a dollar plus. If you look back at the ordinary annuity ordinary annuity, what do you have there? You have 0.909 at 10%. So a dollar plus the 90 cents a year from today is $1.90, which is annuity due now 2 years, and then 3 years and 4 years and so on. So you can easily see that it's either at the beginning of the year or the end of the year. At the bottom of the page, I gave you a couple of examples, how to convert from an ordinary annuity to annuity due, how to convert from annuity due back to ordinary annuity. So if you want to go from annuity due back, what is the real difference? The real difference is a dollar today, because in the annuity due now, a dollar today is worth a dollar. In the ordinary annuity, a dollar a year from today is not worth a dollar. It's worth 90.909 cents, right, at 10%. So if you, for example, and I think the example I gave you was using 8%. Let's look at annuity due 8%, 5 years. What is your factor? 4.312. Now, if you want to go from present value of an annuity due 5 years to present value ordinary annuity for 4 years, what do? You take the 5 year, you subtract one, that gives you 3.312, and go to 4 years because you're taking out that dollar. A dollar today is worth 1.0. Get rid of that, and you're back by one to 3.312, and you'll see 8% ordinary annuity, 4 years, 3.312. So you just take one minus one and then one less year. But you can look at that and read it and you'll see the example clearly, how we're going from one example to the other, and it's a nice simple way to kind of understand how to do it. Now you'll see in the next page here again is an example working on, and there's the factors. For 1 year, 0.91, 0.83. Here's 0.91, 0.83, 0.75, 0.68, 0.62 is 3.79. That is the present value factor. That's an annuity. That is a lump sum, each of those. So as you look at that, you can see we're using the formula. We're coming up with the amounts. Then you'll see on the next page the journal entry, which we're rounding to 924 just to make my life easy. So what's the journal entry? Based on what we learned, credit bonds payable always for face. Debit cash, 924. Difference is your discount, which is what? In this case is 76. That would be your journal entry to initially set it up. Then what do you have to do? Then we're going to have to take the concept, take this, and we're going to have to amortize out the discount. Earlier, to keep it simple, KISS, keep it simple, stupid, KISS. Earlier, what did I do? Earlier, I just said, let's keep it simple. Take the $100 divided by 5 years, 20, 20, 20, 20, 20. That straight line, beautiful way to do it. Unfortunately, it is not acceptable for GAAP. So therefore, what do we have to do? Instead, what we had to do is we have to go through and figure out the effective interest table, which is using a whole different calculation. That's something that we need to understand. That's something that we need to do, but we're going to do that in just a minute.